firstly, you need to understand what are the profit drivers in your business. Once you understand that, you need to collect the data which links to those traits. I'm Darren Hamblin. My wife Melanie and I have been living here for 20 years. We breed Wagyu. We have normally around about 6,000 head. I found that they had the larger difference of low to high value animals, and I wanted to reach the high end. And by putting a lot of work into those animals, genetically and genomically, I could reach the top end of that, and the money is there to return that investment. The reason we went to Wagyu is because we had trouble with fertility. It really kicks that away from the first cross. When you get there, you start to realise the real traits that people chase Wagyu for as the meat-eating quality, which is initially, and still is now, I guess, the value of the carcass is driven by the carcass weight and the marble score. Now, to give you an idea, we can have a swing in value of $2,000 to $3,000 for the same animal that's cost you the same to breed and feed. So you can appreciate why we want to aim for the top end of that. Where we're heading for now in the future is more of the detail in the marble, so the fineness and distribution, because even though now we're not paid on that, I know we will be, and I don't want to be 15 years behind that trait. So the data that we use to make those decisions on breeding our animals firstly started out just looking at the size and the average of that size offspring, the average of their trait. So the average marble score or carcass weight of all of his offspring, link it back to the sire, and then you can rank your sires. Now that's a quite an accurate way of doing it, which served us for 20 years. We do the same for the cows because we record the dam of each carcass. So the traits we select for, initially we start with fertility. When we finish AIing our cows, 35 days later we ultrasound scan, preg test them, and we keep the fertile ones. The next in line, I would say, would be the carcass traits. Now the issue with them is they take 4 to 5 years to get that information back, so it's a very slow feedback. The other traits that we have introduced of late are the polled trait. Now that's been done in conjunction with two other Wagyu herds. So now we've started on a high base and we can move on throwing all our best genetics together, but keeping that polled gene. And the polled gene is not that hard to follow. What is hard is making sure you don't lose focus on the key traits. The first thing is to collect data, I guess, and so crush side we have to use software which is individual animal. Well, we use stock books and EID readers and scales all feeding into that. That's what most people think is data collection, but for us it's everything right down to going out in the paddock on your horse, catching a calf and writing down its mother, its date of birth, its sex. So everything we do is data collection. When we give chemicals, vaccinations, we record what we give to each animal, we record the batch numbers. It's for data collection so we can analyse that later on, but it's also traceability of everything we do. So if anyone ever asks me what chemicals or drugs one animal's had, I can show them. Whilst that served us well for 20 years, we got to the stage where we wanted to delve deeper into that because we noticed that even with the same sire and dam, you get variability in your outcome. So we started to use the SNPs. Now SNPs are singular nucleide polymorphisms, which is a much more accurate way of describing the genome of an animal. So we analysed the relationship between the most predictable traits connected to the SNPs. So now we know which ones they are and which ones are the most linked to any particular trait. And if we know the sire and we know the dam, we know the chances of the combination being the outcome we want. Everyone wants a predictor on their trait immediately, which can be done now using genomics. Bearing in mind, whatever predictor we use has to be linked back to some actually collected trait. So luckily for me, I've collected that for 25 years and now I have the genotypes to link back to that data. So the beauty of having all this information allows me now to go back and rethink about what traits we need going forward. In reality, what we need is we need to produce good meat for consumers, but there are also other considerations that we can now focus on, and some of those are net feed intake of animals. There's a lot of concern around about how we are working with the environment. We've done a lot of work with net feed intake. Now, what that means to me is we can produce a kilo of good meat with less grass than we have had in the past. Now, with that information connected to genomics, we can also select on those traits. So for those people who want to make progresses with genomics, I believe their best way to do it is by using breed plan. It'll be the best indicator they can get because it's linked up to other people's animals by genomics. However, the best way for them to get a really good predictor is use that technology to its best extent, and that is put a lot of data in. There's no way around putting a lot of data in. You can use everyone else's data and think you're going to get by on the back of their information, but it's by no way as good as having your own data.